See, now with boom spray, you can take a neglected truck like this and turn it into just a couple sprays. And you're gonna turn it into, see that? One spray, boom! Look at that. Hey, welcome to the channel, Ouzo channel. How's it going, everybody? Hopefully great. Today's video is gonna be about, we're gonna be detailing this Chevy Silverado. That's a buddy of ours. He's always helps us out on working on our cars. He helps us out. So today we're gonna hook him up and detail his neglected truck. This thing's hit. And first, what we're gonna do on it is we're gonna use the Chemical Guys citrus wash and gloss right here. And we're gonna be using the power washer. We're gonna have this stuff in a foam canning. And this video, I'm not gonna film the whole process of detailing this. This could be like my other videos. I'll just show some of the stuff and steps we're doing. And we're gonna see how well this stuff foams, stuff like that. And then we're gonna have to do a polish on this. It's got a lot of swirl marks on it. Probably pick it up in the hood. And then we'll wash it, we'll check it out. We're gonna have to clean it up real good for them. But we'll get going with this. You guys check it out. And then I'm gonna be starting up the gas powered pressure washer in a minute, and then we'll get this baby going. So stay tuned. Okay, we got done washing it with the foam cannon. We washed, but what we did with the foam cannon, how I do it is I foam it up real quick, the whole vehicle, and then I'll let it sit for a second, and then I'll rinse the whole vehicle down, and then we'll foam it again, and then we'll hand wash it. And at least that way we try to get as much dirt as off we can without creating any more scratches or swirl marks. It was so dirty. And we already cleaned the wheels and everything. So right now, what we're gonna do, this is the Meguiar's Ultimate All Wheel Cleaner. And this is gonna basically take place of the Car Pro X that we use to spray on the vehicle to see if we can get rid of any iron contaminants on it. So to get any contaminants out of it, so this is a lot cheaper than buying that alternative product, which some of them are from $16 to $20-something. And this you can get at a local store. And how much was it, like 12 bucks? Maybe eight? Something like that. And then one of the stores had buy one, get 50% off. So that's perfect too. And it's just a cheaper alternative. And I haven't tried it yet, so we're gonna try it. And another thing too, if you wanna see a video on someone using this, go to Public Merch channel. I'll have his link below. So check him out, because that's how I got the idea from. He has a video on this, and he's an upcoming YouTuber and doing detailing videos, and great guy and a great channel. So you guys check him out after this video, of course. So let's try it out. We'll spray it down and we'll see if this truck, it might be hard to see with the black, I'm not sure. We'll try it out, shake it up real good. We'll spray it on there. We'll do a little bit at a time. I'm not gonna do the whole vehicle at once. We'll just do the driver's side for now and see what it does. You can even spray down the windows. We'll do the roof. We'll do the whole vehicle actually, but for the video right now, we're just gonna do the side and see what it does. Should turn maybe purple. The other products do. All right, we'll let that sit for a minute and then try it out. Leave a dude on your wheels again, get it nice and clean. And this bottle's pretty full too. Get a lot more product too and save some money. Okay, it's been a few minutes on there. Can't really tell if it's working. I think it is. By other videos that I've seen on white paint, it does work. With it being black, it's hard. I think over here it's kind of like sticking, a little dried up. I think it does work a little bit. So if you're using this in direct sunlight, you know, you might want to work quick. And yeah, but I believe it working. So I'm gonna rinse it all off and then we'll continue to check for tar. But you can see as it dries, look, check it out. It was dried on there. This stuff's really thick too. And it clings to the paint, you know? And look at it. You can see where it's dry, I'm gonna wet it. And look, it just comes right off, like soaks that right up. And I don't see any on the cement, any purple. And I really don't think this truck has a lot of fallout on it from, like, it's, you know, like with my vehicles at that industrial environment. He doesn't work that close to the dusty environment. So that's a good thing. That's work we gotta do. And then we're gonna check from tar. I didn't see too much tar, but we're gonna double check and make sure. And then we'll be clay burning it soon. Get it in the garage. We'll be losing our sunlight soon. Alright, so that stuff works. Good alternative instead of and it smells better too. Car Pro Car X smells, but it does work really good too. And this is just an alternative to save some money. I will definitely order. I still order the Car Pro. I do like it. Do both. Check that out. Looking good. All right, we'll continue to go. All right, guys, look at that. We basically clay barred this, everything. We got the paint clean with those steps. I mean, man, look at this. I think I got my job cut out for me. It is hit. You guys see that? This truck's on a 2018. I'm gonna be using the correcting cream and see what I can do. We'll see if I can get most of these out for him. Look at that. This is bad. Wow. I think I'm gonna have to have him teach him how to wash and ride. Jerry, if you're watching, you're gonna have to come over. We're gonna do one-on-one how to wash. This thing's hit. Wanna hand me that light, that new light that I got? I picked up this light not too long ago. Oh man, see if you guys can see that. Oh yeah, you can see that. I can see it with my new camera. Right. I'm not gonna show the process, but I'll do a section and we'll see what it looks like. It's pretty bad. Gonna be busy. Alright, I did a couple passes on this one. I tried it twice, it's that bad. See if you guys see a difference. There's still a lot of defects in it from before. Maybe you can see right there, right here, I didn't tape it off. But you can see the difference right there. So the correct cream's working, it's not getting all of it. Man, this paint's hit. But it's looking better. We'll keep going at it, and hopefully you can see it here without the light. And right there. Alright. I don't want to take too much clear coat off. We still gotta, you know, try to preserve as much as we can. We'll get it looking good. Yeah, but what I'm ending up doing to get this scratch, especially the hood, is really bad right now. And I broke out my Dyna-Wax cutting cream. Now what I'm gonna have to do is we're gonna have to cut the hood. It's a three-part system. We're gonna cut it, and then we're gonna go to their scratch compound, and then we're gonna go to their, I think it's called, it's cleaning polish. Yeah, that's what we'll go to. So we're gonna do three parts on this. The cutting cream, the scratches are bad, we have to. So we're taking clear coat off a little layer. And then we're going to do the cleaning polish to buff all this out. It's almost like wet sanding it. You can see it, the difference. And then we're gonna go to the scratch compound. And that should level that out. And then we're gonna go to the Dyna-Wax cleaning polish. This stuff is not expensive at all, and it works pretty decent. You just gotta work in small areas, 2x2 sections. It dries up pretty good. If it's hard to, sometimes it's hard to come off, just use your spray, like a alcohol and water spray, and it would come right off. But man, this hood is terrible. I couldn't give it to my buddy with these big scratches on there. I mean, that is just bad. I can't believe how bad they are. Look at that. The hood's the worst. It's just awful. All right, we're gonna continue to go. And I'll show you the results from the hood from after the three-step process. Okay, pretty much done doing all the steps on it. We'll take a look at it. We're here. This thing kicked me pretty good. Kicked my butt. Black's hard to get clean. Yeah, we used... We soaped it up like in the beginning of the video. I used to do some hood. The hood was really bad. I ended up using some Dyna-Wax cotton polish, which that helped. That cotton polish basically worked pretty good. It's almost like wet sand a little bit. It did knock down some of the clear coat. And then I followed it with correction cream. The correction cream did a great job taking all those infections out for that. Now granted, there's a lot of scratches on the hood. This truck was in an accident last year. He hit a deer, my buddy hit a deer, and the body job just did a terrible job on it. And a lot of the scratches, if I'm looking, it might be hard to pick up in the camera, but like right here, you can see the scratches in there. I don't know, to me they're in the clear, in the base coat. That's what I'm thinking. And with it being a base coat like that, so, yeah, because right here, that's in the base coat, man, if you really can see in there. If you start really wet sanding this and that, you're going to just take all the clear off, if anybody. I mean, that's what I think. There's a guy that follows our channel, and we followed his, a pretty cool channel. Yeah, we got a, there's a channel that follows us. He's a body man painter. Camper. I think I said it right. I always say it wrong. iCapper, I think it is. I'll have his link below. He's a body man. Maybe he could comment, watch this video, and tell me what he thinks. I think some of it's in the clear, and some of it is in the base coat. I mean, so how do you, you're not going to correct that if it's in the base coat. They did a terrible job. I told him he needs to take this back to that the body shop and have them. They need to redo this hood and the fenders. But other than that, it came out nice. Nice shine using those products. I got to finish up and get it in the sun. I figure real quick before I get it in the sun, make this a little bit of footage of it. You guys can see how shiny it is. When I put it out in the sun, we'll walk over it and we'll look at it. But man, I've got some hours in this truck. Look at that. You can see my fence and everything. This thing shines. That Chemical Guys HydroCharge works, man. I mean, I got two coats on it. And actually, I probably got roughly about 12 hours work time on this truck, polishing it and getting the paint clean. That hood mainly just, it got me. That's where I wasted a lot of my time on the hood, trying to get as much infection out as possible for them. Trying out different cuts and that. And that's where I lost a lot of time. But oh well, it's getting there. I gotta finish the wheels and stuff like that. And then he'll be picking it up. He's got the Corvette. Actually, he was doing some work for me on the Corvette. So it kind of win-win. My buddy helps me, I help him. And he found a couple other things too that we need to have fixed on the vet, so which is cool. And then he said he'll help us with it. So that's cool. He's a mechanic too, so it kind of helps having a friend as a mechanic. It helps out and you can learn from him. But yeah, it's looking pretty good, guys. All right, I'm gonna finish up, get it outside, and we'll take a little bit of footage of it. Just make a quick video. It was hard to, you know, doing a full detail like this, it's hard to make videos on it. Okay, there it is in the sun. Final touches. It's looking good. Got it all shined up. It's like a mirror. Okay, here's some of the products we used on the Silverado.